Welcome back to The Witcher 3. At long last, we've arrived at Skellige, and it is gorgeous. Beautiful place. Of course, even though it looks beautiful, from what I've heard, it's a rather harsh place that nobody really wants to go to because it's really dangerous. Let's take a look around. Bear fat. Even though it's just a common item, that's by far the most interesting thing in all of this, because I keep running out of it for making potions and stuff. Blood moss, ew. Wow, there's some really good loot around here. A weapon. This one? Yeah, it's this one. Oh, it's a level 14 weapon. I would have been really good at level 14, but not anymore. Now, it looks like there's some... I think those are wyverns. Probably protecting maybe some of the greater treasure. Let's go fight them off. Oh, those are sirens! Those are not wyverns, never mind. I have never fought those before. Ow, ow, ow. Jesus Christ. Starting to panic there. Kept coming at me so fast I didn't even have time to quen. Or if I did, it just instantly got knocked off a couple seconds later. So, what kind of a creature is the siren? I'm guessing a hybrid would be my guess. Yep, it's a hybrid. That picture makes the sirens look a lot more beautiful than they actually are. Maybe some of them look like that, but those did not. Grapeshot, Igni, and Ard. Like skilled hunters setting out wooden ducks to lure in drakes, sirens and Lamias lure men near, using their own bodies as decoys. They can transform to resemble beautiful human maidens, though with tails covered in silver scales instead of legs. Once a naive sailor gets within arm's reach of these beautiful creatures, their fair faces suddenly turn to fang-filled fish-like maws, and lovely tails promising unknown delights become sharp, death-dealing talons. Okay, so they can transform to looking like that. Well, I guess the sirens I just fought weren't trying to lure any sailors in. Because they look so freaking scary, oh my god. Look at how big their mouths are. Filled with fangs. And that is a place of power.
Magic. A place of power.
Was I sure what I was going to spend my next skill point on? I can't remember. Yeah, I started putting it into fast metabolism. Let's keep shoving the points in there for now. I love this music so much. It's
Simon
beautiful.
Ben. Gotta ruin it for them. Ugly bastard.
Oh, hi. Looks like a siren, but it had a different name. It was Eka something. Echinida or something like that? Alright, looks like that's all the chests around the boats. Oh wait, is this one over here? Ah, there's one more. Now that's all of them. Come on, Roach.
Come on.
Let's start on the main quest for now. Go to the port near Kaer Trold. Let's take in the beautiful sights. Oh, look at those mountains up there. And I bet I can actually get up there.
Let's go!
Doggy!
Best blade's not worth shite of a weak arm.
Looks like a wolf, but seems to be friendly.
Wonder where they'll
how they live at the bottom
on the shore at Larvik.
Who are they?
Fierce gaze to protect
you looking for work
black
really
as well.
We've hewn the post.
Time for the chisels.
Must's gotta be worthy of a konung.
Wow, this thing's been carved just out of a tree.
To sail straight and even.
It's beautiful. Kind of strange though. I figured they'd finish it before starting to paint it and everything, but it looks like they've really been like finishing the top before they've even finished the bottom. Before they've even finished cutting the bottom.
Ooh.
Weird.
Listen, Witcher. Got us some weird diablin. You know? Drowners. Real problem. The kind your silver sword could most certainly solve.
Let me guess. They're tearing your nets, devouring your fish, and attacking the occasional lone boatman or tavern patron who walks home along the shore.
Were that the only harm? Terrors in the bay are meaner than on the continent. They hunt come dusk or dawn. They attack fishermen wielding just oars and warriors alike. Sea tosses them up after. Armor shredded, guts devoured.
Strange. Any witnesses?
Rurik, my apprentice. He was on a boat the Muir Diablin attacked. There's Tove, too. Her man was killed. She lives nearby, up a bit. Sorry, none of that comes to mind. Those who see the beasts, meet them, well, they generally don't come back to dry land alive.
I'll take the job. Dealt with drowners many times. It'll soon be over. Got my word on that.
Well, I got a contract, but I still want to focus on the main quest for now.
Consider settling in Kaer Trold.
Why can't I play today, Dad?
We've got to go to the port. Bid farewell to King Ron.
It's not me the player.
Gotta slow down here a bit. Want to take in some of the local life? Listening on some conversations? Looks like somebody here needs some help.
Sorry to trouble you, but I really have no choice.
What is it?
Our ship was wrecked against the rocky shore during the last storm. I've lost everything.
How am I supposed to help?
I haven't even got the coin for the journey home, and with each day's delay, I draw closer to bankruptcy.
Might have guessed you'd come around to coin. So, need a loan? Or is it just alms you're after?
I shall pay you back every last copper, I swear it. You need only call on me at my address in Novigrad.
Yeah, sure.
Fine, I'll help you. I visit Novigrad often enough. Might stop by, see how business is going.
Thank you. You'll find me in the port district. My name's Johan Bonner.
See you later, then.
150 is chump change to me. Might help the guy out. He might never pay me back, but it's fine.
He's raised Dunar's villages.
You don't say.
This here's a calm village.
Oh my god, isn't... Wouldn't she be cold? She has bare legs, and it's snowing.
Our time amongst the living is but the wink of an eye. What's left?
You need not do this, child.
I know, but I want to.
Is madness. Such a young lass.
Erna should be the one going. They shared a bed longer.
Silence. It is her decision.
Is she actually killing herself along with him? Yennefer.
You look beautiful.
Thank you. Nice to see you again. The eulogy.
King Bran of Clan Twirsech has embarked on his final voyage. At its end, our glorious ancestors await him. Together they will hunt and raid. They will sit round the fire and praise the deeds of ages past. For now, he lives in our hearts. One day, we too shall stand at his side and face the sea together. That will be a good day.
You knew Bran?
Yes. He was well respected. Unlike his wife.
Skellige is its clans. In times of war, tradition holds the clans unite under the leadership of their king. We've bid Bran farewell. Time to pick his successor who will lead us against the Black Ones. The gates of Caer Troll stand open to all who hail Bran of Clan Tuirsach dear. Mead and meat will be plentiful. During the wake, those who believe themselves worthy of the crown will step forth.
These people on Skellige, these clans, they remind me really heavily, and this whole place reminds me really heavily of, what are they called from Game of Thrones? The Ironborn, is it? Like the Greyjoys? And all the other clans? I think they're called the Ironborn, but I'm not 100% sure. But it just reminds me very much of them. You know, living on islands, being hunters and raiders, using boats, having clans. Reminds me really heavily of that. Do I want to go to the wake or not? I guess I should. I mean, I'm new here. I guess I should try to be as respectful as possible, if nothing else. I don't want to just, you know, be a foreigner on this island, come here, and then just disrespect the hell out of all of them. It's a bad start.
Come to the wake with me.
Gladly. Feasts in Skellige, so predictable. Slobbering drunks, brazen boasting, and the inevitable rows that result.
Yeah, nothing like the banquets mages attend. Remember the one on Thanet?
You were there. How could I forget? I also remember excruciatingly well what happened after the banquet.
Reading my mind again?
What's more, I like what I see. Did you learn anything in Velen?
Velen. Awful place. Somehow Ciri wound up at the castle of the local ruler, a baron, self-proclaimed. This was after she was injured.
Injured? Was it serious?
Don't think so. Must have recovered because this baron sent her on to Novigrad. Think she was looking for you at the time. These witches Ciri came across, she was lucky to escape them.
Witches?
Creatures, more like. Can't say exactly what they are, but they're dangerous. Very. Also ran into an old friend of ours in Velen, Kira.
What on earth is Kira Metz doing in that wasteland?
Hiding from witch hunters. Listen, she told me an elven mage had been there looking for Ciri.
Good. You'll need to tell me more when we have some time.
Been to Novigrad. Ciri was there, looking for a way to lift some curse. She's not there anymore.
You're certain?
Heard it from Dandelion, with no embellishments.
Do you know any more about this curse?
Not much. Ciri ran into some trouble, never finished what she went there to do. I recovered a phylactery. She was looking for a way to enchant it.
I'll look at it later.
How about you? What have you learned?
Something strange happened on Ard Skellige a time ago. A disaster brought about by a burst of magic. Extraordinary, really. Natural anomaly. Never seen anything like it. My intuition tells me Ciri was its cause.
As much as I respect your intuition, Yen, we need something specific. Evidence.
I'd know for certain if I was able to inspect the disaster zone. Unfortunately, Ermion and his druids aren't letting anyone near.
Ermion's head of the Skellige Circle? Haven't seen him since,
since Ciri was a little girl. I doubt he'll do you any favors, not even for old time's sake.
So why won't Ermion let you inspect the area of the anomaly?
Call it a difference of opinion. A large, loud difference. Look, it's Krach.
Wait, Wolf!
Greetings, Krach.
I shall see you at the wake, and I'll not accept any excuses. I've an important matter to discuss with you.
I shall wear black and white for the feast. I count on you to don something complimentary. Something that doesn't reek of a thousand hunts.
Yen, you know I can't stand new doublets. Just too tight till you break them in.
And just like Krak, I'll not accept any excuses. We're not here to enjoy ourselves. We've matters to resolve and should dress appropriately. I've rented a room at the inn. Took the liberty of laying out some clothes for you there. You ought to go. Choose something. In the meantime, I've something to attend to. We'll meet at the entrance to the feast hall.
Ooh, so I get to play dress up again. I hope she meant that literally and that I actually get to pick out what I want to wear. Yeah, let's do it. Let's go put on some fancy clothes. Where is the inn that I'm supposed to go to? Where is the inn? Shouldn't it be marked on the map or something? I guess I'll just go to where it tells me to go. Of course, I've also got a good collection of clothes on me, but I don't think I have anything black and white.
Ooh.
River, don't eat so much.
Why the spit not?
Because if you get hit from a gun, those herrings get tangled in your entrails. There'll be no hope for
you. We should serve our king worthily.
Shouldn't eat or drink too much for
one day. We'll meet again.
After though,
as we'll all meet again, Bran.
Is this part of a ritual? Looks like there's a hatchet right there, so maybe. This place seems pretty ritualistic, especially what happened on the boat with that one person's. Who was she? Was she his lover or daughter or something? I'm not quite sure, but she went with him on the boat, burned to death alongside him, I guess. And they also had a bunch of animals on the boat when it was being burned too, as like offerings or something.
Last night
I saw a cow, I think, and I think a goat too. Ooh, a barber. Okay, I've actually been meaning to visit a barber. I want to go back to how Geralt was before.
Greetings.
Smooth seas this morn, as if the gods themselves were paying their respects to the great Konung Bran.
You a tailor?
I am. Only one in the Isles, most like.
Take it you're good with scissors. Give me a haircut.
It ain't something I usually do, but it wouldn't be right to turn down a traveler.
So is this the only guy who can give haircuts on this place? I think what I had before was long and loose, right? So talented, he can uncut my hair. There we go. What about the beard? I'm pretty sure I wasn't too happy with the other beard styles. Mustache, mutton chops. Yeah, I guess it's either the full beard trimmed short or clean shaven. I think those are the only two ones that look pretty good. What does clean shaven look like again? Long hair, clean shaven. Let's take a look. No, I like the beard.
So long.
Now, he said he has clothes too, right? He's a tailor.
Hey, Shusta. Glad they look at what you...
Wise man.
So what do you have? Anything fancy? A shirt. Well, it is white, but it's just a common shirt. I want a fancy shirt. Yeah, I don't think there's anything here that I want. some elegant Skellige shirts. Actually, do I have those already? Elegant Skellige shirt, elegant Skellige shirt. Yep, still got that. Skellige tunic, tunic. Yeah, I've already got all this stuff. Jesus Christ, I have a lot, don't I? Let's sell some of this garbage. Yeah, good enough. Got him down to, 4 monies left. It's got no money left.
So long.
Come see me again sometime.
Alright, so let me just check. I'm supposed to put on new clothes to meet with Yennefer. Can I just put on whatever I want? I mean, if I've already got a Skellige tunic and all that stuff. Oh, God. I look dashing. Is that good enough to satisfy the quest? No, but maybe it's got to be a complete outfit, not just the one piece. I should probably go with the elegant Skellige shirt. Has elegant in the name, so I guess it's fancier. And yeah, let's put on all the other pieces of stuff too. Skellige festive slippers. Yeah, just put on Skellige everything. And sort this stuff, it's completely jumbled up. It's still jumbled up. Eh. Gloves, gloves, gloves. Oh, I never had any... I never got any dress gloves, did I? I don't think they sold those, no. Okay, so pants, Skellige breeches. 2 different kinds.
Right. Just not something I'd ever wear. But what don't we do for our... Who exactly is she to me?
Actually, let's see if I can put on the blue one. Even though it doesn't have elegant in the name, I'm curious if it will accept it, because it looks so much prettier.
We serve her who
yeah, blue
her
one's fine.
Mother and crone.
Wait, why is it telling me to go backwards? Can I not reach it from there? Well, GPS is telling me to go behind me, but this should lead to it.
You see, Lugos is fetching for a fight. Not for the black ones.
Look at these sheer cliffs. Oh, wait a minute. I need to get up there. Maybe this isn't going to lead to it. Unless there's, like, an elevator? Ooh. Actually, I think there is. Is it coming down?
Where are you going?
Yes, it is. Very slowly, but it'll be here in a minute.
You certain?
I feel like I'm about to scale the Great Wall, separating the north from the even more north, the wildlings.
Friends we show heart, foes we show our axe. Remember that.
Up here. Listen to that.
Bran was a great ruler.
He needs a worthy successor.
You speak as though you have someone in mind.
Skellige's troubles very much derive from it not being a hereditary monarchy. Any upstart can be king and destroy his predecessor's legacy.
The King of the Isles is a more symbolic position.
That should change as well. A strong leader who wields true power. That is what the times require.
I'm Geralt, a witcher.
Berna, Queen of Skellige. I'm glad we've met, but you must forgive me. Duty calls.
I can see you chose your own outfit. You know, of course, that together we look about as good as lace frills on a battle axe.
Everyone's got their style.
Is she saying my style is crappy? Because these are actually all fancy clothes, and it's actually really pretty looking. Although, I just realized I forgot to take off my cat school gloves.
We should mingle before they all get drunk. There'll be no talking to anyone then.
Good thinking. I don't know what Krach wants, but when we meet with him, we should have clear minds.
I'm not gonna drink. Why dull my senses when I'm in such pleasant company?
Do you plan to compliment me all evening?
I plan to tell you what I think.
Wonder if he's as strong as he looks.
Want to fist fight me and find out? Alright, let's take off the feline gauntlets. There we go.
So, what have you brought
for
the farewell feast?
Bread, sheep's milk, cheese.
Our wagon's full of loot to be ripped from the black ones.
We've also wine from the temples of Melitta.
Geralt, there's something I've been meaning to ask you.
Hmm?
Your beard. Why did you decide to grow it out?
Don't really know.
Must say it suits you.
I do think it suits him, doesn't it? It does.
Lady Yennefer. Sir.
Greetings, Arnvald. My companion is Geralt of Rivia.
I am honored.
Nice to meet you too. Quite a few guests.
They come to bid their king farewell. They come to see the claimants to the crown.
We wanted to talk to Krach on Crate.
The Jarl will join us shortly. He's assigned you a place of honor at the table just beside his daughter Ceres. Follow me, please.
They've seated us here.
I asked them to. Wanted to meet the notorious witcher Geralt.
We've met. Don't remember?
That was ages ago. Yalmer and I were children when you last visited Orda. But you should meet your feast mates. Allow me the dubious honor. That's Halbjorn, son of Holger Blackhand. Blue Boy Lugus, Madman Lugus's firstborn. And choking down a stockfish over there is Otric on Hindar.
Seems they set us with the sons of Jarls, exclusively.
Ceres on Crate is the daughter of a Jarl, Geralt. Jarl's daughters are in no way inferior to their sons.
Do you know every last one of them dreams of being Bran's successor? Look at him. Likely lot.
Ceres is jealous, for the one among us who performs the greatest feat will be crowned king.
We all know the feats are a sideshow. Our fathers will choose who will wear the crown. What do you think they spoke to Krach about?
You talk like that because you're short of strength and skill. Remember when Hjalmar challenged us all to a race up the mount? You didn't stand with us then. As he buried his axe in that stump at the top to mark his victory, you were warming your chicken bones by the fire.
Had my reasons for not participating, but I would have won then, as I'd win now.
Now you mention him, just noticed Hjalmar's not here.
My brother walks his own paths. But about the race, why don't we repeat it? I'm willing to challenge any of you, Witcher included. If I beat him to the top, venture to say that'd be a feat, eh? So you in?
If the Witcher's in.
Hell yeah.
Geralt?
Let's do it. Let's do it right now.
Gladly. What are the rules?
Whoever pulls Hjalmar's axe from the stump at the top of the hill wins. Stray off the path and you lose.
And here I was, ready to puke from all the boredom. Let's go! We're here. From this spot, you must reach the top of that mount. At the summit, you'll see the stump of an oak, Yalma's axe buried in it. Whoever pulls the axe from the stump first wins.
I'm ready.
You'll start when I sound the horn.
Shall we put some coin on it, Lugos?
Oh, I thought we were gonna have horses. Oh well, that's fine. Let's go.
Hurry it up, old man!
Alright, I got this. Bah! Bah! She's not even close to me. I'm like 5-10 seconds ahead. Axe is mine. I think we're almost there, right? Yep, there it is. Got it.
I won, but only by a hair.
More like 10,000 hairs.
No such thing. There's winning and there's losing, and I lost. We best go back to the week.
Let's.
Wonder what would have happened if I threw the race and actually lost on purpose.
See the wakes in full swing.
Lost sight of yous. Who won?
I lost.
Lost to a witcher, Sparrowhawk. That would likely happen to any of us. Enough of the natter and let's drink.
Would I be insulting them if I didn't drink? I don't want to drink, but... Well, if they are insulted by me not drinking, then too damn bad. Deal with it.
Can't today, for good reason, believe me.
But if not today, then when?
You've been great company. Sadly, it's time we moved on.
Really?
Indeed. We must talk, but not here. You shall learn all beyond that door.
Ooh. I don't know if what Yennefer just said is ominous or exciting. Should I be worried? I don't know, but let's go ahead and spend our character point. Another point into this. I'm going to be able to drop my toxicity super fast, I think. Just keep shoving potions inside of myself.
Do you have no shame?
Shame? Why would I?
The queen should join her fighting on that last year.
What did you say in the reason to us?
The gods of London came back alive. Our isles are so hard to hold just a
short time. I recognize your type on my
Tell me.
Allow me to introduce Geralt of Rivia, a witcher. Geralt, Jarl Donar and Hinder, and Jarl Madman Lugos.
Calling Lugos a madman's an insult to madmen? He's a common goat fucker.
Call me a goat fucker one more time, and I'll chop off your head, stick it on a pike, and piss down your neck hole.
Enough! Time to settle this. Here and now.
Oh, ha ha ha! Giving me a true fright right now. Shat my best trousers. Put that away before you cut yourself, you cunt.
I feel like they might actually just kill each other right here and now. And telling them to calm down is not gonna work. There's no way. They don't give a crap about me telling them to calm down. This is their own thing, and honestly, that'd probably just make them even angrier.
Settle this outside.
Who the fuck are you to advise me, eh?
Someone with better manners. You insult Bran's memory and Crax's hospitality with this.
Emperor would be very pleased to hear you quarrel.
His Imperial Majesty is more than welcome to visit.
Let him sail over here. We ain't afraid of the Black Ones.
Raiding coastal villages is one thing. Total war with the Empire is another.
Awfully mouthy, this one. Go stir your cauldron and pierce some boils, witch. Don't talk when you haven't got a fucking clue.
Nope. Not gonna lose my temper.
Calm down, Lugos.
No wench will teach me how to fight.
That was not my intention. Come, Geralt. I believe this discussion's run its course.
Yeah, this is rather boring. Tiresome people.
What now?
Now we pay a visit to Ermion's laboratory.
Didn't know we'd been invited.
Because we've not been.
Oh, I can't say no.
Take it, Ermion won't be there.
That's right.
And what's the purpose of this visit?
We're looking for an object. The Mask of Erberos. We'll need it. Come, Geralt.
Now you'll need it for what? Need this mask.
Oh, I shall. In due course.
Take it, you'll decide when.
Correct.
Would appreciate if you could just tell me right now, but okay. There's too many things to loot down here. I'm not gonna even try.
Footsteps. Shh. Guards. Hide behind the tapestry.
Sparrows chip, while starlings chirp.
What do jackdaws do?
Jackdaws caw. Goldfinches warble, and cranes whoop. Whereas peacocks screech. Hawks scream, larks trill, and doves, they coo. That's all of them.
What about nightingales?
Ah, right. Nightingales croon.
That was close.
I feel like Yennefer and Geralt are gonna have sex in Ermion's workshop.
This'll be tough to open.
Surprises never end. See the ravens?
Hard not to.
Ermion's spies. An indication that we're near his laboratory. I also sense a clear magic aura. Come, there's a ledge outside this window. We must pass along it.
Seen uglier sights in my life.
Geralt of Rivia, being romantic.
Did she just teleport? I think she did. But yeah, look at this view. I wish I could go into first person mode. Look at that. Beautiful.
Hobby can render a man mysterious. Fascinating.
Especially a druid. Must be a real nature lover.
Rawr.
Had one at Kaer Morhen.
Please.
100 loose an arrow if you saw that in the woods. Looks alive. A basin of water?
For teleprojection. A reflection of Ermion appears on the surface. Supplicants speak to it.
This is a massive fire hazard. The flames are literally touching the bottom of this tapestry. I would have caught on fire long ago. Thankfully, this place is mostly stone, so I guess even if it did burn, it probably wouldn't be that big of a deal.
Ah!
Are you all right?
Cut myself. The door is locked. The animals, they're alive. Yen, watch out! Monsters. Feel them coming closer.
Am I on like a drug trip or something? Jesus Christ. The deer's gonna fight me too?
What's happening?
You were hallucinating. You ran at Ermion's animals, sword flailing. I had to calm you.
We never mention this again. It'll be the downfall of my reputation.
Looked strange.
Your years of vigorous training at Kaer Morhen finally paid off. Bested nearly all the stuffed beasts in here.
Please.
Fine. We've passed the trial of taxidermy. The door stands open.
Am I a real witcher now?
Let's go inside, Geralt. I'll lock the entrance. We don't want to raise suspicions. Dear Druid's laboratory. We must search it thoroughly. The Mask of Urbaros must be here.
Letter bearing Ermion's seal
world of
to the Druids warns
Ritual
them about you.
Plant.
Well, they're talking over each other there. I'll just read it on my own. Brother Druids, be forewarned that a sorceress has arrived on Ard Skellige. Her name is Yennefer, and she hails from Vengerberg. I know you are immune to feminine wiles, and will not let a well-draped skirt muddle your reasoning. Nevertheless, I warn you not to be taken in by her intelligence and refinement. I know who Yennefer is. I do not, however, know the true goal of her stay in Skellige. I see no point in asking her this question directly, for Yennefer is known for her cunning and eloquence. She says not what she thinks, but what she wishes you to hear. You must remember, this is no second-rate sorceress. This is a person who breaks bread with the rulers of the North, and who most recently has been working with the Nilfgaardian Emperor himself. Familiar with courts the world over, She possesses an ability to manipulate that even the wildest diplomat would envy. Or... wiliest? Wiliest diplomat would envy. Yennefer has displayed an unhealthy interest in the site of the cataclysm we are striving to study. I have not given her permission to go near it, but I caution you to keep your eyes and ears open all the same. The sorceress from Vengerberg is a stubborn and effective manipulator. I know that in the past, her and Croc's paths crossed. I suspect that she will wish to use this old friendship for some ulterior purpose. What that is, exactly, I will try to determine. Once I do, I will inform you in a separate letter. May the power be with you, brothers. So that's why they don't want her to investigate the site. They think she's up to no good. And they're trying to block her out of everything. So they're watching her.
Ah, what do you know? Raymond Marlowe. A biography enhanced.
Seems Ermion has real tobacco brought in. Dwarven triple mead.
Triple mead? Is that just three meads blended together?
Goes in for light reading, too. The Corpse of Novigrad by Sasha Hadi.
What is the Corpse of Novigrad? Alexander Ho walked down the long corridor, delighted that the sounds of debauchery pouring out of the rooms drowned out the sound of his footsteps. The long-neglected brothel floor creaked and moaned, as though the wood regretted being witness to the lecherous scenes fed to it by this house of ill repute standing in the very center of the pride of the northern cities. Ho had been generously remunerated for this visit by the wife of a silk merchant. She had long suspected her husband of dabbling with loose women during his working hours. The case had seemed simple enough, banal even. A cheating husband. How many similar affairs had he unraveled? The worst was that his employers never truly wanted him to bring irrefutable proof of their husband's guilt. On the contrary, in their heart of hearts, they always hoped his investigations would prove their husband's model citizens, and their suspicions wholly unfounded. This time, it truly did turn out that the woman's husband was no whoremonger, despite the fact that his trail led Alexander to a place in which fleshly pleasures were bought and sold. The door in front of which he stopped, following the instructions he had received from the gnome at the entrance, had a small plaque with the number 16 on it. Unlike the other rooms, this one was enveloped in an unsettling calm. Ho turned the doorknob and pushed the door open. And what he saw behind it far exceeded his worst expectations. I'm guessing he found a murder scene. He said the woman's husband was no whoremonger, but the name of this is the Corpse of Novigrad, and he said the room was strangely quiet, an unsettling calm. So, maybe not a whoremonger, but a murderer.
Laboratory worthy of an imperial alchemist. A goat carved out of lindenwood, signed to Uncle Ermion.
Little Ciri's handiwork. That's what she called him when he was her tutor.
Secret lever to open this doorway, perhaps? Or can it be broken? Nope. Probably a lever somewhere.
Looks like Ermion places something in the statue's hand. How about a mug of mead? Statue or not, everybody needs a drink sometimes. Seems like it worked. Who would have thunk?
That was easy. Ermion enjoys jests achieved at the expense of others. I have a sneaking suspicion the mask will be in here.
Look at this. A detailed map of the Northern Kingdoms. Even shows spheres of influence over the ages.
Out of date.
Geralt, come here. I found the mask.
Oh, hold on. I still need to investigate this.
A sword in a stone. Things begging me to pull it out.
Oh, come on, you can do it.
It's not in the stone, don't you see? It's held there by a vice.
Pinecone. Didn't expect this. A large female.
Ermion's wand. He's one of the few druids to use one.
Alright, now that I think is... Oh, no, one more thing.
A child's skull.
I think we're gonna have to fight a golem here. Or an elemental.
This is it. We've got it. We must return to the feast quickly before...
Are you exactly? Yes, Earth elemental, okay.
It's a trap.
Elemental oil, I think I have some. There it is.
We're in prison.
Damn it. Come on, come closer. Gate's still closed. Gotta think of something quick.
Oh, we're getting gassed. Okay. Burn thing. That did nothing. We're gonna die in here.
The damn druid will poison us. This vapor's deadly. We've got but a few minutes.
Teleport us out of here.
Think of something. Quickly. First thing to come to your mind. Hold on tight.
This has got to be Yen's room. She always did like space.
Damn. I tore a hole in my dress. Wait a minute. I must mend it.
You know how to sew.
Please. I'll enchant a needle.
Wouldn't mind watching. Oh, so sexy. Yeah, let me see you sew your dress with an enchanted needle. Us witchers really go for that magic stuff. Let's be a pervert witcher and see where this goes. This could be really funny. Oh. When he said wouldn't mind
Wait.
Watching, I didn't-
For what?
We must talk to Krach.
Why? Think he misses us? Because I missed you.
I didn't think he was gonna take all his clothes off when I picked that option and just try to have sex with her right then and there.
I missed you too.
When are you gonna finally burn this piece of junk?
My heart couldn't take it. So many memories. Damn it, Geralt. Do you have any idea how much they cost?
Come here. We gotta hurry. Croc's waiting.
Is that so?
Yen, let go of the mane.
I know you. I let go, you throw us off. Don't even try.
I'm so glad I picked that option. I didn't realize it would lead to that, but I'm so glad I did.
My, oh my.
Sex on a unicorn.
Missed you.
I missed you too.
We ought to get back to the wake.
I must dress. Turn around.
Croc and Kreator asked about you.
We went out. For a breath of fresh air.
The claimants to the throne will step forth in a moment.
Now heed my words. There is no greater act of valor than to fight a beast cursed by men and gods. No greater deed than that done to serve the goddess.
Words of uncommon beauty. We thank you, and we'll take them to heart. But now, let's begin. We have seen Bran off to the Beyond, and must now choose his successor. A king must be wise, a king must command respect, a king must have bollocks. We've no lack of men like that. Let those who feel worthy of the throne of Skellige step forth. My son could not be here this day. Behold his axe! Behold his will!
Ah, yes! She's going for it.
May the best man, a woman, win!
What's got into her?
She's your daughter, is she not?
Now I know why she said she'll sail to Speakerog.
Aha!
Children! The older they grow, the more trouble they are. Come with me. All the more essential we talk now. How was it, Geralt, when Ciri was nearing womanhood? I remember well her Nan, her mother, what they were like. They say the apple doesn't fall far from the tree.
Ciri was impossible to control. No telling her what to do. Had to have things her own way almost always. Why do you ask?
No specific reason. She and Ceres, they're of a similar age. But we'll speak of my children later. First, let's speak of yours. Yennefer claims Ciri's in trouble, and you seek her.
That's right.
If you require aid, gold, ships, anything, merely say the word. I'll give you all I can. And I know the last lives. I'm sure of it. When the blood of Rhiannon's daughters is shed, the sea grows white with fury. I'd mark such a storm.
Magic anomaly on Ard Skellig somehow related to Ciri, or so Yennefer believes.
It's my strong suspicion, but I can only know for certain by examining the site.
I saw the twisted forms, right unnatural. The druids were barely able to contain it. Explain to me, Yennefer, how Ciri might have caused this great catastrophe.
I'm intent on learning that very thing. Which I will do as soon as Ermion stops hindering my investigation.
Don't concern yourself with him. Druids have little trust for mages. But Ermion's heart is in the right place. Am I right to assume he does not know you seek Ciri?
It's of no concern to him.
As I thought. At any rate, Ard Skellig's my isle. You've my permission to investigate as you see fit.
Wondering if I should talk to Ermion.
Leave that to me. Go. Seek and find your Cirilla. If any ill befell her here, an Ard Skellig on my watch, I'd never forgive myself.
Thank you.
No need. I swore an oath once. I aim to keep it. Anvol, tell the druid I must speak to him. At the usual spot. I've one more matter to broach. My children. You remember Hjalmar? Well, he swore an oath to kill the giant of Unvik. Set off and has yet to return. But as Ceres announced that she's to set off on an adventure of her own. Got it in her head that Udalric is not mad, but cursed.
Take it Ceres wants to lift the curse.
There's no curse to speak of. Ceres has decided she must match Hjalmar and sought out a deed worthy of a queen.
Think she might need my help? You did plan to ask me for it. Why?
The thing is, I don't trust Udalric further than I can spit. Ceres won't listen to me, or her brother. Yet confronted by a professional who will explain why she's mistaken, she just might come to her senses. So, yes. I ask that you explain things to her, and bring her back.
Giants. They've been extinct for ages. Anyone actually seen the one on Undvik?
Aye. Dozens of refugees have. The giant drove everyone off the isle. I've welcomed what remains of Clan Tordaroch here on Ard Skellig.
I heard a rumor that an unnatural frost gripped Undvik before the giant appeared.
It's true. At any rate, Hjalmar decided to kill the giant and give the isle back to its people. A deed worthy of a king, he believes. My son gathered a hearty crew at the new port. They were to sail to Unvik, then travel on foot to Oska, the village. But that many lads should have killed the giant long ago. Thus, I thought to ask you.
You should start at the new port. Ask around. Hjalmar might have told someone there his plans.
Can't help wondering. Got no plans to vie for the crown yourself? Think a good number of the Jarls would support you.
A good number? Those opposed would be fierce, rabid. Madman Lugus would sooner see an Nilfgaardian on the throne. Besides, a man should know when to step aside. Hand the tiller to the youth among us.
If either Hjalmar or Ceres need help, I'll help them.
I thank you.
Now that we're done thanking one another, let's get to work. We must determine if Ciri is still on Ard Skellig. I'll change into travel attire and find you. Head south. The anomaly we should investigate destroyed a stretch of forest along the shore of the bay. A successful feast on all counts, Clark. I will see you later.
I kind of like this croc guy. He seems really trustworthy. Anyway, I think this is a pretty good place to end the episode. Got this wonderful view of this crazy, stormy landscape. I hope you've enjoyed so far. And when I return, I suppose I'm probably going to meet with Yennefer and investigate the site where the strange magic thing happened.